shit behind me. Keep my diamonds blinding. Gotta keep it suave like I'm Sade in the 90s. Hey guys, what's up? It's Kiara here. I thought I would give you guys an official car tour. You loved seeing my how I bought a car, and if you haven't seen that video, I recommend seeing the video to find out how I bought this car and why I chose this car. I have a Mercedes GLA 250 from 2017. I bought it used. It was a lease return, and I got it from DNC Motors, and I thought I would show you guys what I keep in my car, all the features that I know of as of now. Let me show you around. So this is the outside of the car. Over here, one of my favorite features is this little triangle. It has blind spot assist. So this triangle will illuminate yellow if a car is like getting close to you. And then if a car is literally in your blind spot, it'll be solid red. My other favorite feature of this car, when my keys are super close to me, this is how you lock the car, just by touching the outside. And then this is how you actually unlock the car, and it'll do all four doors. And then in the door over here, obviously opening the door, lock, unlock. And then this seat controls all my different seat adjustments, so I can bring my backrest forward and back, and I can move the seat up, down, forward, side. And then these are all the different settings, so I can put in all my settings for different people that want to drive the car. We haven't really figured out how to do this very well, so I need to read the manual because I've only had this car for a month. In the door, this moves my mirrors. Over here, this is how I control all the different windows. And the thing that I really like about it is it has some great details. I need to start the car. Okay, now I got my keys, so I'm gonna try this again. You put your foot on the brake to start the car, and then you press this button right here, and you can actually take this out and put the key in and use that to start it, but I obviously like the button start. Once the car started, then you can press it all the way down and the entire window rolls down. And then you can just do like short little presses, or you can press it all the way up and it rolls all the way back up. The AC is really nice on this. I like it a lot. It's 92 degrees. So yes, it is very steamy. Down here, I have my different lights. This car has auto lights, which I love because my old car was a 1999 Nissan Pathfinder and it didn't have that. The parking brake also automatically comes on when you park the car. So say I wanted to drive this right now and I had it in drive. I lift my foot off the brake, the car's not gonna go anywhere until I actually press the gas. A little Prindle, if you guys watch that. From London Tipton, so I call it a Prindle too. This gear shifter or whatever is up here instead of down here, so it frees up a lot of space. And then this is how you put it in park. You just press this. My car has an upgraded stereo. It's a Harman Kardon. This whole thing up here is a speaker. I've got my screen here, which is really nice. So I have Apple CarPlay. This isn't a touchscreen, but I control it through this little dial, so I can flip through all my selections and things like that. And then you just press it to select. You can go back to the menu. I thought that would bother me a lot about the car, but it actually isn't that bad. I don't mind it at all. This is the wheel. Really simple, which I like. It's easy to use. If I just flip through these different controls on the screen, it will flip through like miles per hour. And then this is really cool. The car has like an eco display, so it's showing like how well you drive the car in terms of doing well for the environment. And there's different settings that you can do, and if you get the entire circle green, then you're driving like the absolute best you can, I guess. I don't really know how to explain it. I usually just keep it on the range, and it tells me how many miles I have left to fill up my car with gas. When I drove my Nissan Pathfinder, it sucked gas like crazy. Like, it used to cost me $60 to fill up a tank, and if I did the Eugene to Portland drive, I would go through an entire tank of gas no matter what. Now if I go the Eugene to Portland drive, I only use half a tank of gas, and my tank is 15 gallons. I haven't filled it up from like the very, very bottom, but if I fill it up and it's like got an eighth of a tank left, it's around $33, which is way cheaper than before. We have time here, speedometer. I really like that these are still like the actual analog clock style, if you will. And then it's got a screen here, but it's got some depth in it and detail. There's dials here to answer the phone, change the speakers, things like that. This is super cool. You can control these like an airplane, so they pivot really nicely. And then if you twist it, it turns off. Mercedes kept this little detail in just as an allude to the old Mercedes, and I don't really use that. I also have a CD player if I ever want to. And then radio, navigation. I have heated seats. I love heated seats in Oregon in the wintertime, so that's been really fun. This car is all-wheel drive. Okay, yes, I don't have my seatbelt on. It's beeping at me. I can put it in snow mode, so it'll show you a bunch of data and interesting stuff. I haven't really played around with it. This is the one. I'm still learning how to do this. The other thing that's really cool about this car, you can't really see it right now, but I have
interior ambient lighting color. So I can basically change this to be whatever color I want. Right now I have it set to pink and I really like this color pink, and you can change the brightness and things. So at night, wherever the handles are and during like in the cup holder seat, you can kind of see that pink light in there. Car will lightly illuminate pink, and when I shut the car off, it just cycles through all 12 of the colors. This is like a reverse cruise control. Oh, and I also have cruise control. My thing's down here. I got all the air control over here, another little compartment. I have a nice big cup holder right here. I often just keep my phone in here. I also have two cup holders here if I have my water here. This armrest can slide forward if it's more comfortable for me. Here, I just keep all sorts of goodies. I have my tripod for vlogging, two pairs of sunglasses. I have little cleaners to clean the inside of my car, tissues. I got some mints that my dad surprised me with, a pen. Chapstick is a must, and I have a hair tie. Well, I guess I'm almost out, but the little car wash stickers, these are the best gifts. So that's kind of everything I keep in there. And then I have this plug, which connects to Apple CarPlay and charges my phone at the same time. And then this one is just another USB to charge your phone. So if your friends are in your car and you want to charge your phone, you can do that. I have a glove compartment right here, and I just keep the owner's manual and a reusable bag. I have the little mirror. So there's a little mirror plus light. This is a bunch of other little fun stuff. Have my Oregon Ducks chain that hangs here. My dad's friend got this for me. It always reminds me of him. This car also has the moonroof, so it goes all the way back and you can control it by pressing this and the shade comes up, or you can lift the entire thing off like that, which is kind of fun. And then this is a view of the back seat. It doesn't look like from this angle there's a lot of room, but from what I've heard from my parents and my friend sitting back there, there is a good amount of room. It's got vents down here, so you can like open and close these, and you can put either this seat down or you can put those two seats down. You've got compartments here, which are also really nice because I can fit my hydro flask there if I want. And I'll show you in the back. There's Leah, she's being a trooper. This is what the back looks like. It's got compartments right there, the little fan thing. This is another little outlet so you could charge your phones there. And then here, oh, I don't even really know if I've done this before. Oh, it's like a little cup holder, and then you go like this. And then we get to my favorite part, the back of the car. My 1999 Nissan Pathfinder also had a hatchback, but it didn't do this for you. And I know this is like not very exciting, but when you upgrade from something that was made in 1999, every feature is exciting. Over here, I just keep this bin. I have a bunch of like hand sanitizer, a brush. I keep coins in here. And then I have a bunch of my reusable bags. And I also will put returns or things that I want to take back to the store in my little compartment, so it's all organized. And then this is one of those safety road kits if I ever need it. And it has Velcro on the bottom so I can like move it around and it stays there. I've got a first aid kit here, and then under here, this is actually the amp for my stereo, which is insane. Up here, there's a button and you just press it and it closes. So that's my entire vehicle. That's what's inside my car. I hope you guys enjoyed seeing inside. Super comfortable. It's a great purchase for me. And I know it's not like the perfect car for everyone, but I'm really happy with it. And I've had no buyer's remorse. And yes, I bought this car with my own money. I am the only name on the car. So if you guys wanna hear me talk about credit and go on for a rant, go watch my other video of me actually purchasing this car and telling you what other cars I was looking at in comparison to this one. I think it's hopefully a helpful video if you guys are in the market to buying your first car or your second car. That's it for today's video. Thank you guys so much for watching. If you guys are shopping for a car right now or have a dream car, let me know what it would be down below. I'm really curious. I'll see you later. Bye. Don't you know I'm way too weak to swim? Can't you feel the waves come crashing in? Running out of safety nets, cause every night, every night, hey! I fall down.